What is going on, YouTube? What's going on? Welcome back. We're going to talk a little bit about chapter one. So if you haven't seen chapter one, go and watch it right now. I don't want to spoil it for you. I'm not going to spoil chapter two. Don't worry. We're here to talk about chapter two. But in order to do that, I got to talk about something that happened at the very end of chapter one. This is your final warning. Go watch it. So at the end of chapter one, we discover a baby Yoda. And I was blown to bits. I don't even know how I did the last review and didn't spoil that for you guys. I'm telling you right now, that was one of the best jaw-dropping moments in TV history. At least for me it was. Especially the fact that this show connects so well with the series. We know that Yoda's already long gone because this is after episode 6. So it was one of those, like, what the hell? Like, what does this mean going forward for the Star Wars franchise? What does this mean going forward for this show? Does he die? Does he get killed? Does the Mandalorian fail on his mission at some point? You know, it's like all these questions rise. And with Chapter 2, nothing is answered. Because in Chapter 2, they do a lot more of what Chapter 1 was, which was keeping the show grounded. Instead of taking us to the next, you know, the next plot point, the next storyline. No. Something happens where things just stay the way they are and they need to solve this issue before we could go forward. And let me tell you, man, I just love the sound effects. A1 right there. The sound effects, beautiful. The cinematography, the CGI, everything just feels like a movie. I don't even feel like I'm watching a show. I feel like I'm watching a piece of a movie, like a long movie cut up into pieces. It's just outstanding what Jon Favreau and his team and Disney has done with this show. Everyone bashed The Last Jedi. Everyone talked crap about, Star Wars fatigue and all this crap. But The Mandalorian has shown that if you do it right, even if it's not the best thing ever, because obviously there are probably better shows out there. There are shows that have much better pacing, but I don't care. I love the pacing of this show. I love what they're doing with it. I'm sorry. Call me a Star Wars fanboy. I don't think it's that. What I love is that movie value put into an episodic series. You know what I'm saying? And in this episode, there's some action sequences where they didn't cut around the budget. Like, they really did a phenomenal job. And I think that's going to be something that I have to mention with each episode as long as it's there. Because if it was sloppy, we would have been tearing this show to shreds. But this is A1 quality, guys. Like, Jon Favreau sat down with his team and they masterfully thought everything out. Like, I feel like the team they put together for this show needs to continue pumping out shows. I know they're doing The Mandalorian season 2, but they need this universe. I want to see more of it. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to just see The Mandalorian. Like, this is just one guy, one story. I want to see more. And the fact that now Baby Yoda's involved, I don't know if Baby Yoda's going to get killed before the end of The Mandalorian's journey. We don't know that. We don't know what's going to happen. So, and that's not a spoiler for chapter 2, by the way. I'm just saying for the series going forward. I just think that this show has so much potential to set up other shows and other universes within the Star Wars universe. Since we're already going away from the Skywalker saga with Rise of the Skywalker or Rise of Skywalker, right? With this final installment of the Skywalker saga, we need more of other Star Wars content. We can't just depend on the Skywalkers, you know? And to be honest, I'm a little sad because I'm a big Kylo Ren fan. So I want them to do something with Kylo Ren. Like, I think Kylo Ren would be the perfect character for another series on the Disney Plus app, to be honest. I feel like there's so much to explore there. I feel like there hasn't been enough storytelling for Kylo Ren. And I think that they should do something with him, like prequel-wise, like they did with Darth Vader in episodes 1, 2, and 3. You saw him turn, you know, you saw Anakin turn into Darth Vader. So I hope that they do something like that with more of these characters, like the Mandalorian. This is a guy that they really just, you know, made up from thin air. And it feels like a genuine, authentic Star Wars experience. And that's what I'm here for, you know? Again, it's not that it's the best show ever. You could talk about the pacing. You could talk about how chapter two, nothing really happened. But the way that things play out, the way it was shot, the art behind everything that was done for this show, like, you could see it. It's right there. And I just love the tone, man. Like, I think they captured it. I think they captured what I would have envisioned this type of show to be. You know, and I didn't even know this is something that I wanted, but now I want more of it. It's like I'm getting addicted to this show. Like, I can't wait for Friday to come around, and I'm gonna be so sad when that final episode, I think it's only 8 episodes. So when episode 8 airs, I'm gonna be very, very sad because I just want more of this. And chapter 2 just made me want even more. And that's what this chapter here does. It doesn't further anything, it just keeps it. You know, it keeps it within a small circle and kind of builds character within, you know, I just don't want to spoil this. So I'm trying to like beat around the bush. But I feel like they build on what they already have created on episode 1. And there's a little more of everything on there. And it's something that you know, we're starting to see what the Mandalorian is all about, like the character himself. We're starting to see what type of decision making he has, and we could kind of get a feel for his thought process. I still don't get the guy fully yet. I don't know what his motives are aside from being a bounty hunter, but this episode does reveal, you know, it's like they're giving us breadcrumbs. So, you know, this review was mostly about the entire show and the production value of it over the actual chapter, and I'm sorry for that. I just wanted to really give them credit for what they've done and what they could do going forward. I am not Star Wars fatigued. Give me more of The Mandalorian. Give me more of this universe because I want it. And Gina Carano's in the show, but I haven't seen her yet, so looking forward to her character maybe making an appearance in Chapter 3. Let's see what happens. I'm really excited. I'm really excited, as you guys can tell. Comment down below. Let me know what you guys thought about Chapter 2, what you guys thought about Chapter 1, what you guys think about this series, the Star Wars universe. I don't care. Just comment down below. Let me know. If you're not subscribed, subscribe. More reviews are coming. Thank you for tuning in. I'm out of here. Peace out.